Hello everyone, I am back again with this video, and in this video I am again going to teach you that how you can make a perfect introduction for an IELTS essay. In this video we are going to discuss three essays and the introductions of it. So as I told you in the earlier video that our introduction must have around 40 to 50 words. So that doesn't mean you cannot have 52 or 53 words, plus minus 5 words is okay. But you should stick around 40 to 50 words. The second thing, your introduction should cover your question completely. Now, if you can see the question of my essay, the first line of my question says, it is too expensive to look after and repair old buildings. So it is clearly saying that it is expensive. So this is my main keyword. My main keyword should always be visible in my introduction. The next line says this money should be spent on building modern buildings instead. So in the first line it was talking about old buildings, and repairing of old building is expensive. The third main keyword is modern buildings. So my all keywords should be visible in my introduction. So my main three keywords: expensive, old buildings, modern buildings. So if you can clearly see my introduction, I have used the word expensive, I've used the word old and historical building, I've used the word modern buildings. So a lot of teachers say, or they tell you to just paraphrase the lines, but that is a failure way to write the introduction. The best and the most effective way to write an introduction is to pick out the keywords and write those keywords in rough, and then you can make an introduction out of it. You just need to write 40 to 50 general view of your essay. So if you can see the first line, I have agreed with the statement of the essay that no doubt that repairing and maintenance of old and historical building is expensive, but this doesn't mean that this money should be spent on modern buildings only. I have given my slight opinion, I have given my slight view that I do not agree with this thing, that the money that is being spent on the old buildings repair and looking after them should be spent on the new building. So I have given my slight opinion that the development of the new buildings must coexist with the preservation of the old ones. So it is important to make new buildings, but it is also crucial to maintain and preserve the old buildings. So I have given my slight opinion, I have given my slight agreement as well as disagreement to the essay in my introduction, and I have also written all the main keywords that were given in my essay question. I repeat, my main keywords were expensive, old buildings and modern buildings. So I have written all these keywords in the introduction. So I will wait for a couple of seconds, quickly take a screenshot of the introduction for this essay, and then I'll move on to the next one. So if you see the second essay, this says the age at which people are now having children has risen. So this is my first statement of the essay. The second statement says some people believe that because of this, the families and the countries will suffer some problems. So my main keyword is that people are having children at later stage of life, late, and they say, some people say that this is because, and this will cause problems to the families and countries in future. So these are my three main keywords: problem to countries, problem to the families, and age has risen. So I will use all of these keywords in my introduction. So if you can clearly see in the first line, I have eventually agreed to the statement and given my slight opinion that no one can deny the fact that people are now having children at later stages of life. So I've just used some vocabulary, I've just used some synonyms. So it has risen, I have changed this word with at later stages of life. Now in the next line, I've also given my opinion, a bit of opinion, that this trend could be dangerous if it persists for a longer period. that this can be dangerous. Yes, it can be problematic if it goes on for a longer period of time. Then I've given my opinion again. I reckon that people could face a lot of issues in families, and some countries might struggle to keep up with the demand of labor. I give you an example. In Japan, they have an aging population. Around 70 or 75% of people are old. So they are struggling to get the labor for industries, for markets. So they're not going able to get the labor. But this is an example which I'm going to write in my second or third para. But for now, I'm just giving you an example that how you can put up some things which can relate at the later stage of essay. So I've written, I reckon that people could face issues in the families, and also the countries might face struggle to keep up with the demand of labor. Because if the population is aging, you cannot get labor easily. So these are the problems that can occur. So I've given only one problem, that's it. I have not explained this problem in detail. Never give an example in your introduction. The introduction is only the general view of the essay. And in introduction, you must always include all the main keywords which are given in the question of your essay. So this is how you write introduction. We'll quickly do another one. Okay, so this essay says that many people are copying famous celebrities from TV and magazine. So my main keywords are copying the TV and the magazine celebrities. And why is this happening? So my answer is pretty simple. People watch TV. Definitely they watch TV. They watch TV daily, every day for 1 to 2 hours. And I've written the same thing. You can see the first two lines. TV and magazines have a great influence on our lives. Most people watch TV for at least 1 to 2 hours in a day. Then in the next line I've written, people tend to follow the celebrities they like, and people imitate their style. Now imitate means copying. So here the word was copying, and I've replaced this word by imitate. So people imitate their styles and looks in order to look different. But I believe that it is not a healthy trend. So this question is asking about a trend, that why is this happening. So in my next paragraph, I'll give the reasons why is it happening, but I don't want to give reason in my introduction. You should never give the reasons in the introduction. You must never give the advantages of something or disadvantages of something, or your strong opinion in the introduction. You must never give your strong opinion in the introduction, and you must never write an example in the introduction. Introductions are only a way to express the heading of your essay. Your introduction should always include the main keyword from the statement of your essay. So this is how you write perfect introductions for IELTS. And if you have any questions regarding this, you can place your questions in the comment section. I'll try to give answers to each and every one of your questions. Thank you. Bye-bye.